Why do we gender AI? Voice tech firms move to be more inclusive. Gender-neutral voice assistants and accent recognition among projects in the pipeline. Technology that can understand regional accents and gender-neutral voice assistants are among the developments expected in the voice technology field in 2020. Products such as Alexa and Siri have faced mounting criticism that the technology behind them disproportionately misunderstands women, ethnic minorities and those with accents not represented in datasets that have historically favored white and Chinese male voices. In response, a wave of new projects aims to redress the balance and make the growing voice tech industry more inclusive. Dr. Charlotte Webb, the co-founder of Feminist Internet, detailed some of the current technology's shortcomings. Voice tech has failed by not being programmed to respond adequately to abuse, she said. The example of Siri stating "I'd blush if I could" when told it was a bitch is a well-known example, as is Alexa replying "Well, thanks for the feedback" when told "you are a slut." A study for the Washington Post asked people to read out different news headlines, and then looked at what Alexa thought people had said. The difference between what was said and what the device understood was 30% greater for people with non-native accents. Recent research also indicates that Google's speech recognition is 13% more accurate for men than it is for women. Feminist Internet has developed a chatbot called Fxu in an attempt to raise awareness about bias in AI systems, including voice technology. Another enterprise that intends to make voice tech more inclusive is Project Q, a gender-neutral voice assistant expected to launch in 2020. Current voice technology is essentially gendered, says Ryan Sherman, a creative developer at Project Q. When we look at Siri or Google Assistant, they all predominantly start out as female by default, so we started out with that question: why do we gender AI? Research shows that female voices are more helpful, compliant, and more subservient. Whenever male voices are used within AI technology, it's used to telegraph superiority, intelligence and more commanding qualities, an example being IBM Watson. All voice tech only offers two options and the world has moved past only seeing gender as binary. Project Q launched in 2019 with a prototype voice developed by non-binary linguists. They then asked a sample of 4,500 people from across Europe whether it sounded male or female. The answers were split 50-50. We are now working on developing this as an actual voice that can be used across voice assistants but also metro stations, games. There is huge scope, says Sherman. He is also optimistic that transforming the sonic architecture of everyday life can change attitudes. Q is a voice to break down. For more on this story, visit the news article link.